Hello, my name is Dr. Abraham Yan, and in this channel I go over problem solving strategies mainly in math competitions. So this is a problem from IMO 2022. This is problem C1. A plus minus sequence is a sequence of 2022 numbers A1 through A2022, each equal to either plus 1 or minus 1. Determine the largest C so that for any plus minus 1 sequence there exists an integer k and indices T1 through TK that they differ by at most 2, and the absolute value of the sum is greater than or equal to C. So when they say the largest possible value of C, what we need to do is to do this. First, we'll have to show that for every plus minus 1 sequence, this sum exists, this Ti is greater than or equal to C for some Ti. And we also need to show for some sequence, this sum of ATI is less than or equal to C for every TI. So let's just start looking at the smaller cases, sequences of length 1, 2, 3, etc. See if there's a pattern. We can come up with a conjecture, and then hopefully we can prove that. Let's say CN is the answer for plus minus 1 sequences of length n. And the question is asking us to find C sub 2022. So that's what they're asking us to do. Let's just start with n equals 1, n equals 2, etc. So for n equals 1, clearly C1 is 1. Well, there's really two possibilities, and 1 and negative 1, both of them give us 1. So if for n equals 2, the answer is C2 is 1 because we have a sequence 1 minus 1. That's basically the optimum sequence, and we can just choose 1. For n equals 3, we have a sequence 1 minus 1, 1, and this one gives us C3 is equal to 2. Whatever the sequence is, we can choose the two that are 1 or the two that are negative 1. And of course, the distances are not going to exceed 2. For n equals 4, we would have 1 and 1. So I'm going to assume that there are at least 2 1s. If not, we're going to negate everything. Now we have 2 negative 1s. The 2 negative 1s could be here, or we could have 1 negative 1, 1 negative 1. So for this one, we would choose this, and for this one, we would choose this one. So it looks like for C4, the answer is also 2. For n equals 5, we have a similar strategy that we can use. We can have 3 1s, and then we have 2 negative 1s. We would have 2 negative 1s here, or we could have 2 negative 1s here. If the bottom one, this would be the optimal case. The top one, we could choose these 3 1s, and then we could choose one of the negative 1s. So C5, the answer is also 2. For n equals 6, we would have 3 1s and 3 negative 1s. That's one possibility. If we have 3 1s, then we would have, let's say, 2 negative 1s here, or rather 1 negative 1 here, so that we could choose these 3, and then we could choose one of these, and that would give us C6 equals 2 as well. So there are other possibilities for 6 as well. We could have 3 1s and then 3 negative 1s. Here, so we could choose these 3 1s, and then we could choose the middle negative 1. That would still give us 2. And we really can't do better than 2 because you can space the 1s out like this. So really the best case would be to choose this one and these 2, and then one of the negative 1s. And if I go for negative 1s, then again I can't choose all 3 negative 1s, so the best case would be 2. So for n equals 7, I would have, let's say, 4 1s, and then we can place the negative 1s in the middle. If I place the negative 1s in the middle, so I have 3 negative 1s, let's say I place 2 of them here and one of them here, then I would get this one, which would give me 4 minus 1, so that would be 3. So C7 gives me 3. Or what I could do is I have 1, 1, 1, 1, and then I could place all the 3 negative 1s here. Again, I would be able to get to 3. I can't do better than 3. For example, if I space them out like this, So this would be 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1, 1, less negative 1, 1. So if I choose all of these ones, those are too far from each other, so I'll have to choose one of the negative ones. And if I choose all three negative ones, I have to choose 1, 1. So it is pretty clear that there is a pattern. There's a period of 4 here. 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, and then I have 3. So my guess is that Cn plus 4 is equal to Cn plus 1. So I was trying to come up with a strategy to, in fact, prove this one. Now, looking back at what we did, if you look at 4, n equals 4, well, we wanted to choose the two ones, but we realized that if we do that, then they could be sometimes spaced apart, and that would mean the two ones are not going to give us 2. We had to choose the two negative ones. So I realized because of that, it looks like maybe multiples of 4 are going to be a little bit of a slightly different strategy. Looking at 2022, 2022 is 2 mod 4. So I decided to focus on only the numbers that are 2 mod 4. Let's say I'm trying to figure out C sub 4k plus 2. So what is that? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show that this one is in fact C2k plus 2 is, or rather 4k plus 2 is in fact, let's see what we got. For 6 we got 2, for 2 we got 1. So it looks like it should be k plus 1. So this is what I guess. And if that is the case, then 4k plus 1 equals 2022 tells me that k equals 505. So that means C sub 2022 is likely going to be 506. So I'm going to prove this one. So first thing is, if I look at a sequence of length 2022, I'll have to show that there is a sum that adds up to at least 506. So look at the sequence. So there are at least half of them, 4k plus 2 over 2, of the same sign. Let's assume that all of those are plus 1. If not, just negate everything. So we have 1, 1, there are 2k plus 1 ones. And now in between them, we have a bunch of negative 1. x1 negative 1 here, x2 negative 1 here, etc. So from each of these blocks, we have to choose half of them. So if you have 3 negative 1s, you can just choose the middle one. If you have 2 negative 1s, you just choose one of them. So we choose half of them. So we have 2k plus 1 ones that we're choosing minus the rest of them, 2k plus 1, but we're going to choose half of those so that they are spaced at most 2 apart. So that means this would be 2k plus 1 minus k. So that gives us k plus 1. So this means C sub 4k plus 2 is at least k plus 1, because we showed that with this algorithm we can find a sequence that the sum is at least k plus 1. Now I want to create a sequence that the sum of none of those sequences is greater than k plus 1. So we're going to space 1s apart and also negative 1s apart. So 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1, so that we are kind of forced to pick one of the negative ones. And then 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1. So this is one of them. This is one pile, etc. So I'm going to have k piles like this. 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1. So that would be 4k, and then I'm left with 1, negative 1. So let's choose a sequence here, and let's look at the sum of these ATIs. Well, the sum of these ATIs is either positive or negative. Let's assume that this sum is positive. So if that's positive, let's look at the sum here. So my claim is the sum in this sequence by induction is always going to be less than or equal to k plus 1. So the sum here is always less than or equal to k minus 1 plus 1 by inductive hypothesis. Now here, if you're choosing two of the numbers from here or three of the numbers from here, the sum here cannot exceed 1. And when you add these two, the sum becomes at most k. So In other words, to just be clear, I'm proving that if I have a sequence like this, then the sum is never going to exceed k plus 1. And I'm proving that by induction. So that is if the sum is positive. If the sum is negative, so I'm going to do the same thing, but in this case, I'm going to assume that the sum is negative. If the sum is negative, then I'm going to look at this sequence, but I'm going to start from the right side, from the side that has a negative 1. So it would be still 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1, 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1. So we have 4 here, 4 here, etc. So 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1, and then finally 1, negative 1. So we're going to look at these 4 consecutive terms. So 1, negative 1, negative 1. So we have these 4 consecutive terms. Now, if you look at the sum here is at least negative k minus 1 plus 1, basically, because its absolute value is less than or equal to k. And the sum here is greater than or equal to negative 1. We cannot have anything that is less than negative 1 because we cannot choose the negative ones. So if we add the two up, we get that the sum here is greater than or equal to negative k plus 1. So that tells us that the absolute value of the sum is less than or equal to k plus 1. So in both cases, the absolute value of the sum, and by the way, in this case, the sum would be k less than or equal to k plus 1. In both cases, the sum in absolute value is less than or equal to k plus 1, because in this case, it was positive, and in this case, it is negative. So that means the answer is, in fact, 506. And that brings me to the end of this video. So I will see you in the next video.